for maximum fun, we want to combine high voltage, water, and dry ice. This is a little negative ion generator. It's about 7,000 volts, hooks right to AC. A couple of different places sell it. Electronics Gold Mine is one of them. The ground goes through the power line, and that's the negative high voltage. And then we need cookie tray painted black, or get a non-stick black cookie tray. Dry ice, chopped up into little pieces. Add some water, not too hot, room temperature water. Don't want it ice cold, but real hot water doesn't work either.
Some dry ice chunks, and support your cookie sheet on high voltage insulation, styrofoam or plastic cups or something.
Add high voltage. Oh, these things are about 60 microamps, so no real electrocution hazard. Plug the thing in. And if it works, I should get little zaps. Oop, yeah. Let's move the chunks out of the way so we have a nice layer of fog in the middle. And wave your hand around. Ooh, see that? If it doesn't work, lick your fingers and touch them to clothing, because you want to pick up microscopic pieces of lint. There's a good one. Look at that. Ooh, or actually two. Oops, running low on dry ice. Here's a piece of paper torn, paper strip taped and shaped into a triangle. If I hold this above it, watch what happens. See the triangle? Oh, let me try again. Millions of little airflows come off the torn lint, torn fibers of the paper. It's electric wind following the lines of the E-field. Well, here are some sharp needles from the negative ion generator. They have a different effect. Blowing huge airflows, disrupting the fog layer. It appears that conductive metal shoots out fairly high current, you know, microamps, whereas organic fibers, they're down in the nanoamps or maybe picoamps. But still, there's enough of an airflow or an ion flow or whatever this is to punch little slots in the fog. More experiments with this high voltage air thread phenomena are on my website. There are things like you can use deflection plates. I had 60 cycles, a few thousand volts, and made the threads move back and forth. And when I moved a charged object near them as well, I could see a sine wave. So I made a mechanical oscilloscope drawing sine waves in the fog. If you blow across them with a soda straw, it doesn't disrupt them. They'll move a little bit. So whatever these are, they're going very fast, like maybe tens or 20 mile an hour compared to the flow of air through a soda straw. The original phenomena was discovered by the late Charles Yost, a Tesla coil experimenter. He ran Electric Spacecraft Journal. That journal is still going. But he discovered them using scalarin photography. He was looking to see if any kind of E-field phenomena was visible, and he found these strange lines. I always wondered how you could visualize or work with those besides using scalarin photography. And then in 1998, at a Seattle Weird Science meeting, we were playing with dry ice chips, and I happened to have the high voltage power supply, and I was using needles to blow the dry ice fog around. And when the high voltage wire sort of swung across the layer of fog, it carved all these little valleys in there. I wondered what the hell was going on, and it turned out that lint clinging to the high voltage wire on a another negative ion generator used as a power supply, the lint on the wire was spitting out these little filaments of whatever it is, and as that moved across the dry ice, the fog layer and the hot water, it made little lines, and that's how the current bunch of air thread experiments started. Oh, if you do a lot of work with these little 7,000 volt low current power supplies, you might want to build one into a nice little case. Less chance of spilling water on the 120 volt connections.